And for those that don't know, it's Wake County's finest king of the state, Madison Jay. 919 is the longitude and latitude. For those that don't know, tap in and tune with the greatest, man. I'm here, WallyDTV. We live in effect. Let's work. Yeah. See, well, the latest project that I dropped was my sophomore album, Diastema. And I'm gearing up to release my third studio album.
So I'm saying, like, you got any deals on the table?
Nah, everything is indie. Throughout my career, though, situation had came across the table, but it just didn't make sense at the time. But everything that, you know what I mean, that's been going on from then till now has been done strictly indie. So, you know what I mean?
How you move is like you already signed. Somebody done swooped you up, doing, you know what I mean?
It comes from being a student of the game, you know what I mean, more or less, and kind of just knowing how to maneuver. You know, granted, it's still a long ways to go, but it's just, you know what I mean, one thing that I learned is, like, you know the saying, like, move how you want to be treated. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Or basically, like, you have to, if you want to see yourself in this position, you got to move like that already. Mm-hmm. And that's just one thing I always took into account. It's like, yo, move like you already on, or move like you're in the position to be on, because at the end of the day, that's how you want to be gauged. That's how you want to be looked at from the people.
You gotta be working on your next step and the step you're in right now.
Most definitely. Most definitely.
100%. So look, you got a Reebok deal?
Yeah, man. Things is with the Reebok situation. It's something that is definitely, coming to light at the end of the day. It's a beautiful thing that's getting ready to come out. And what's so crazy is the situation with P and Baron Davis. It's a possibility of them acquiring the rights to Reebok. And you got to understand what that does for the culture, and also understand what it does for me in terms of having some type of foresight in order to bring in that to the spectrum, because I've had a love for Reebok for years. So, you know what I mean? At the end of the day, the sponsorship is something that definitely, like, ink is drying. You know what I mean? We're just planting the seeds for everything else to what's about to come and take place.
That's dope. So today, was it like a deal on the table, like they approached you?
Oh, definitely. I had to reach out. Okay. And it's more or less been like a feverish pitch, but I was determined, like, you know what I mean, going to crack some type of doors open. Mm-hmm. Because at the end of the day, you know what I mean, the history with Reebok and Raleigh, just with John Wall. You know what I mean? Him having that signature line and leaving that stint with Reebok, and then, you know, of course, you know, him going over. It just something that I felt like really would make sense just on the music side. It's like I said, Reebok has kind of been, you know, been on the wayside, of course, having a story legacy, but I just felt like, yo, I want to be the flag bearer to bringing them to the forefront once again. Mm. Really, I'm going to be real, it's just this, you know what I mean, this city. Raleigh NC, 919, that's really what molded me, because, you know, this has been like the mothership, you know what I mean, going back all the way to the Athens Drive days. Shouts out to Athens, you know what I mean, that was my home base in school where I clicked up with my H Gang Headhunter homies, and that's where everything kind of just with rap, music, everything, just me kind of becoming from a boy to a man, just kind of took off. So from there, in terms of just, you know, learning how to rap, navigating through the streets, you know what I'm saying? Just, you know, again, it's like from a boy to a man. Mm-hmm. And the city from south side, west side, all the way to the north, even to the east side, so much of it has molded me all together into this, like, one melting pot of Raleigh. If anything, I could say I just, like, I have such a splash of each side.
Yeah, yeah,
you know what I'm saying? Like a nice splash that is
what
just...
What side are you from?
I was born on the south. You know what I'm saying? But I would say, like, I grew up, like I said, like my teenage years and kind of adult, it was on the west side. But I've been, you know what I mean, literally all over, you know what I mean, the city. And this is the XXL, for those that don't know, freshman issue. I am inside this issue, page 86. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, page 86.
Dope,
yeah, man. You know what I'm saying? And I look at it, you know what I mean? At the end of the day, man, you know what I mean? I'm going to always say, like, it's a light flex, because I want to be on the cover of a magazine, you know what I mean? But this is, like, the first step of being inside this magazine. And it was to the point of where I used to steal these joints from a food line, you know what I'm saying, just to make sure I had them every month. And then I can go and flip to a page inside this joint and look and see my, you know what I mean, my gap, my big gap inside this joint, bro. And it's like a one of those moments of like, yo, I made it. You know what I mean? I did something. And at the end of the day, it's just for those that's like me, you know what I'm saying, on the grind. Motivation. It's strictly motivation for myself, for the loved ones, and, you know what I mean, of course, for the city, because it can be done. And I feel like Raleigh is definitely at the point now where, like, it's on fire right now. A lot of shit is really shaking. A lot of artists are moving, and that's a beautiful thing to see.
For the inspiring Madison Jay right now.
Right.
What keys would you give?
Definitely, man, you know what I mean? Understand what a budget is. You know what I mean? Understand what a budget is, and make sure that you continue, like, just being you. You know what I mean? Don't stray trying to follow something else. Like, you naturally got it already, but just continue to stay different, continue to stay focused, continue to stay grounded, but definitely make sure about that budget, because at the end of the day, you can make anything shake with bread. You know what I'm saying? Don't give a damn what it is. Like, it's gonna go with that money behind it. But, you know, it's important just to make sure that you gotta allocate it so you know where things are going. And also be more on the legal side. I mean, understanding publishing copyrights and things of that nature, just so, you know, be ahead of the game early. You know what I mean?
Is that like research you did yourself?
Oh, most definitely. And like I said, just going back, like, I'm a student of the game. Like, I treat it like school. You know what I'm saying? At the end of the day, I did, you know what I mean, I did a JUCO, and I did like some tech school, but at the end of the day, it's nothing like being self-taught, and music is what I self-taught myself, like, all the way down to, you know what I mean, trying to read about points, you know what I'm saying, on albums, and understanding, you know what I mean, marketing and promotion and artwork and things of that nature. Like, I really dig and study shit like that. So at the end of the day, again, that's why I move like I move, because, you know, I'm a student of the game. And I definitely will never knock anybody's hustle, you know, never. But it's just like, for me, man, I don't take this shit like, you know, it is a way to, like, really come about the struggle. But at the end of the day, like, right now, I'm good. Like, you know what I mean? My belly never goes empty. You know what I'm saying? My kid's belly never goes empty. You know what I'm saying? I got a roof over my head. I'm clothed. I'm blessed. Like, it's not going to get no worse. So at the end of the day, I just got to love to keep doing this. And then it's just only going to be a plus when that bread comes, you know what I'm saying? When the bag really just drops and it's up from there. Like, you know what I mean? That's just going to be a plus from what I'm already doing now.
All right, so look. You got a motherfucker. I seen you with a billboard, dog.
Yes. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Billboard.
Yes, sir.
What about that?
Like, it goes down to the marketing and advertising, man. Like, I know I had to put a budget aside, you know what I mean, to, you know what I mean, promote myself, and just knowing, like, what that budget means for myself and my team, it's like, what better way to, you know what I mean, promote yourself than on a billboard, you dig? So, like, it was just important for me to make the proper connections in order to do something like that. Get a billboard, have it going on for, like, 3 weeks, man. Like, at the end of the day, who knows who saw that, who got plugged into Madison Jay off of seeing the billboard. So, for, like, other artists, man, I would definitely, like, a jewel to drop is, like, sky's the limit, man. If you can get a billboard in, like, Times Square or a billboard, you know what I mean? Just understanding the geographic locations of, like, yo, where you popping at and where you hot at, especially after putting out music. Yo, if you hot somewhere, like, yo, hit that billboard up so they know, like, yo, I'm here. You know what I'm saying? I'm doing my 1-2, respect me. And at the end of the day, that definitely was a move, is just letting cats know, like, yo, Madison is here. He's doing his thing. He's making this shit shake. You know what I'm saying? He's making it shake. Much respect, you know what I mean? And just at the end of the day, even with the XXL, it's like, yo, certain moves got to be made in order to let, you know what I mean, let cats know. What's that?
The billboard.
Billboard, I'm not even going to hold you. I just would recommend everybody to tap in, like, to get, like, a certain quote. Yeah. Shouts out to Renaissance Marketing. You know what I mean? They're definitely, like, the plugs who got me right. Very good people. You know what I mean? I like how they, you know, how they move, because, you know, at the end of the day, it's a lot of fuckery going on out here. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Niggas is definitely trying to jug for the bag, so it easily could have been a salty situation, but you know what I'm saying? Yeah, and you gotta understand, like, it's not like the streets of where, yo, you know what I mean, you get trip across and, like, yo, I'm about to go see this nigga, or, you know what I mean, some type of retaliation can happen. In this game, it's, like, all legal. You know what I'm saying? Somebody beat you, like, yeah, you could take it there, but it's just like, hey, you know what I mean? You got to be smarter than that. But it's a very dangerous game, especially indie, you know what I mean? Because, you know what I mean, most of this bread is coming OP, you know what I mean, out of pocket. So it's like, yo, if you get jugged for some bread, that could hurt, you know what I'm saying? Especially you're not signed to a label that's got, you know, buku bread to throw out. Nah, that's coming, like I said, out of pocket. So it's like, yo, you take an L, like, ugh, that stings, you know what I'm saying? So you want to make sure the moves that you are making are clear, concise. One thing, yo, ask questions, man. You know what I mean? At the end of the day, if you dropping bread, you got the right to ask questions. Don't ever just, like, let somebody just jug you and run game on you. Like, nah, ask questions. Make sure you know what you're getting yourself into. Do your research. Definitely do your 120s, man, so that way you can be fully in tune in what you're getting into.